Hi, I'm Jim Ward of the Middle Country Public Library, and I'd like to welcome you to episode 34 in our History Bite series. Today, we will discuss the amazing Stanley Cup dynasty of the New York Islanders from 1980 to 1983, when they won four Stanley Cups in a row. The New York Islanders entered the National Hockey League in 1972-73. The team finished well below 500 in their first two seasons. Prior to the 1973-74 season, Al Arbour was hired as head coach, and within 2 years, they had made the playoffs for the first time in 1975. They defeated their rivals, the New York Rangers, in the preliminary round on J.P. Parisi's goal 11 seconds into overtime.
In front, scores! Over! Parisi! That didn't take long!
They were down 3-0 to the Pittsburgh Penguins and stormed back to win that series in 7 games. They lost in the semifinals to the eventual champions, the Philadelphia Flyers. The Islanders continued their steady progression through the end of the 1970s. The team won its first division title in 1977-78 and posted the best regular season record in the NHL in 1978-79. However, they lost in the semifinals to the Rangers. But the team had improved throughout the 1970s and seemed to be on their way to winning the Stanley Cup. In 1979-80, the Islanders were off to a slow start, winning only 6 of their first 21 games. They were 31-28-9 and were in the midst of a 4-8-1 slide when Islanders general manager Bill Torrey acquired second-line center Butch Goring from the Kings on March 10, 1980. However, Torrey had acquired other pieces to the Stanley Cup puzzle, including defenseman Dave Langevin in the offseason and gritty defenseman Gord Lane, who came via a December trade with the Capitals. Ken Morrow joined the Islanders from Team USA immediately after the Miracle on Ice Olympic victory in late February. The Islanders finished the season on an 8-0-4 run and won 10 of their last 12 playoff games. In the Stanley Cup Finals, the Islanders faced the Philadelphia Flyers. After 5 games, the Islanders had a 3-2 lead in the series, needing just 1 game to capture their first Stanley Cup championship. Game 6 started ominously for the Islanders. Reggie Leach beat Bill Smith at 7:21 of the first period, but Dennis Potvin evened the score less than 5 minutes later. A controversial call changed the momentum of the game after linesman Leon Stickle missed an offside call that led to an Islanders goal. The teams were tied 4-4 after 3 periods after the Flyers came back from a 2-goal deficit to tie the game. At 7:11 of overtime, John Tinelli and Bobby Nystrom jumped out to a 2-on-1 opportunity. After only 8 years, the Islanders had won their first Stanley Cup. In 1980-81, the Islanders finished first in the Patrick Division with 110 points and made a second trip to the Stanley Cup Finals against the Minnesota North Stars. The Islanders beat the North Stars in 5 games for their second straight Stanley Cup championship. When the last second had expired in Game 5, Ken Morrow took the puck for a souvenir, and the rest of the Islanders converged on Smith near their goal. Excited fans leaped over the barriers, rolls of toilet paper were flung, streaming to the ice, pennants waved madly, and the players hugged one another. The Islanders showed their superiority by scoring nearly twice as many goals as their 4 playoff opponents, 95-48 in 18 games. They outscored the North Stars 26-16. They set a host of playoff records individually and as a team. Among them were most power play goals, 31, most shorthanded goals, 9, most points, Mike Bossy with 35, most goals for season and playoffs, Mike Bossy, 85, most power play goals, Bossy, 9, most points by a defenseman, Dennis Potvin, 25, longest streak of games scoring at least 1 point, 18 games, Brian Trottier, and most minutes played by a goaltender 2 successive years, Billy Smith, 2,193. The 1981-82 Islanders returned most of the team that had won the Cup in 1980 and 1981, including the core four of goalie Billy Smith, defenseman Dennis Potvin, center Brian Trottier, and right wing Mike Bossy. Those four future Hall of Famers were at the peak of their game in 1981-82. Smith led the NHL with 32 wins and won the Vezina Trophy as the league's top goalie. Potvin, New York's captain, scored 24 goals and finished with 61 points in 60 games. Bossy scored 64 goals, while Brian Trottier scored 50 goals for only the second time in his career. The team was on a roll for 4 weeks, beginning with a 6-1 win over the Penguins when they won 15 games in a row, matching the longest winning streak in NHL history. In the 1982 playoffs, the Islanders beat the Pittsburgh Penguins, the Rangers, and the Quebec Nordiques to advance to their third straight Stanley Cup Finals against the Vancouver Canucks. The Islanders easily dispensed of the Canucks in four games. New York's 3-1 victory in Game 4 at Vancouver completed the sweep and gave the Islanders their third consecutive championship, moving them into the ranks of NHL dynasties, along with teams like the Toronto Maple Leafs of the late 1940s, the Canadiens of the late 1950s, and the Canadiens of the late 1970s. The Islanders of 1982-83 didn't have the stats as in years past. That season, they tied for 6th in the NHL with 96 points, down from 118 in 1981-82. They also had scored 83 fewer goals than the previous season, and 122 fewer goals than the Wayne Gretzky-led Edmonton Oilers. The Islanders finished the regular season strong, going 10-4 in the last month, and they outscored their opponents 62-36. They didn't relent in the playoffs. They defeated the Washington Capitals in four games in the Patrick Division semifinals, then advanced past the New York Rangers and Boston Bruins, each in six games, to move into the Stanley Cup Final. Their opponent was the upstart Oilers, who had scored 74 goals in winning 11 of its 12 playoff games. The Oilers had five players with 96 or more points: Gretzky with 196, Mark Messier with 106, Glenn Anderson and Yari Curry with 104, and Paul Coffey with 96. They appeared all but unstoppable heading into Game 1 at Northlands Coliseum in Edmonton. But Billy Smith, the Islanders' feisty goaltender, and his imposing defense, led by Dennis Potvin and Morrow, were phenomenal against the high-scoring Oilers. They were assisted by centers Brian Trottier and Butch Goring, who both played great defense against Gretzky. The Islanders shut the Oilers down the next three games and won their fourth consecutive Stanley Cup. Islanders goaltender Billy Smith, who held the Oilers to just six goals in the finals and shut them out in 7 out of 12 periods, won the Conn Smythe Trophy as the most valuable player in the playoffs. The Islanders dynasty would come to an end in 1984 when they lost to none other than the Edmonton Oilers in the finals. The Oilers would go on to create their own dynasty, winning the Cup four times in the next 6 years. But the Islanders left their fans with memories that will last a lifetime. To this day, the Islanders are still the last team to win four straight Stanley Cups. I'd like to thank you all for joining us for today's episode. If you enjoyed it, click like, and if you watched on YouTube, hit subscribe. Thanks so much, and we'll see you all next time.